Seek him that maketh the seven stars and Orion, and turneth the shadow of death into the morning, and maketh the day dark with night, that calleth for the waters of the sea, and poureth them out upon the face of the earth. The Lord is his name. That strengtheneth the spoiled against the strong, so that the spoiled shall come against the fortress. They hate him that rebuketh in the gate, and they abhor him that speaketh uprightly. For as much therefore as your treading is upon the poor, and ye take from him burdens of wheat, ye have built houses of hewn stone, but ye shall not dwell in them. Ye have planted pleasant vineyards, but ye shall not drink wine of them. Woe unto them that are with child, and to them that give suck in those days. For there shall be great distress in the land, and wrath upon this people. And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. And there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations, with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them for fear, and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh.
Through the prophet Joel, God spoke of astonishing signs in the heavens. God gave this message to Joel for those living in the last days, saying, "And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come." When many of these signs have taken place, many will try to make an attempt to explain them away as extreme cyclical events rather than signs from God. To be sure, the Bible prophecy clearly shows that God will be the author of them. And we are indeed living in the last days. And in the months of May and June, there have been many signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars. Many were able to experience the lunar eclipse of the year on May 16th that was visible in the Western Hemisphere across the Americas, Europe, and Africa. Some other interesting conjunctions that took place were on June 11th with Venus and Uranus, May 29th, Mars and Jupiter conjunction, April 5th, Mars and Saturn, April 12th, Jupiter and Neptune, April 18th, Mercury, Uranus, April 30th, Venus and Jupiter, and in March, there were three other conjunctions as well. It is hard to imagine, but a large number of people are very unconcerned and are likely to dismiss many of the signs that will take place as random occurrences. In Genesis 1, 14 through 18, it says, "And God said, let there be lights in the firmament of heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and for years. And let them be for the lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and it was so. And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also, and God set them in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth." Always use the Bible as your guide for encouragement, strength, wisdom, and discernment. It mentions many of the things that have taken place and will be taking place in the very near future. Now, one of the main reasons for making this video was to share with you a very rare alignment of planets to light up. researchers are even talking about it being extremely rare, saying we often get Mars, Venus, or even Jupiter joining. But the fact that they're all aligned and evenly spaced in the early morning sky is not only rare, but it is a special treat because everyone can enjoy it as long as you have some clear weather. The moon is in the middle of the planet lineup in the pre-dawn eastern sky on June 24th, 2022. Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn will be lining up in that pre-dawn sky that could be seen in the eastern horizon. The parade of planets will be best seen about 45 to 60 minutes before sunrise on a cloud-free morning. Many have posted online to look towards the east where the sun is rising, and what you'll see is that Saturn is on top, followed by Mars. Many are excited to catch this very rare occurrence in the early morning hours of June 24th, and it will be really nice to see what many are seeing in the sky by video and by pictures. This is a good time to remember that hope is the hallmark of the Christian life. Faith, not fear. Peace as well. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." John 14:27 and Philippians 4:6-7. These are very exciting times that we are living in as Christians, because we know that these are signs of the soon return of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. What I find quite interesting is that the most historically important triple conjunction was the one that was between Jupiter and Saturn in 7 BCE through 5 BCE. Which has been proposed as the explanation for the Star of Bethlehem. Triple conjunctions between Jupiter and Saturn, so-called greatest conjunctions, last took place in 1682 through 1683, 1821 only in right ascension, 1940 through 1941, and 1981. It will not occur again until 2238, through 2239. This has definitely been a year of many planetary conjunctions and signs in the heavens, and shows furthermore that we are indeed in the end times, but to keep looking up, because we know our redemption draweth nigh.
Shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know, him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain, whom God hath raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holden of it. For David speaketh concerning him, I foresaw the Lord always before my face,